Oh, hey guys, it's Jordi here for Cine Cannes. Dad, Nance, and welcome to Copycat Friday, a weekly series in which we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And today we're having a look at the Street View effect from Vince Staples' Fun. Hey guys, it's Jordi here, and like I said before, today we're taking a look at Fun from Vince Staples, the music video in which we can see a very creative recreation of the Google Street View effect. Now they've done it very good, and honestly, we couldn't really figure out exactly the way that they've done it. Their images morph very nicely together just like Street View would do it, and it's definitely a lot more complex than it looks. Now, one thing that we are sure of was that they used a 360-degree camera. To showcase the effect today, we're gonna do it without, so that everyone can follow along. Basically, you could even capture this on your phone. We're also gonna do a simplified version, just like you saw in the intro, but honestly, I think it comes pretty close. Now, before we start, I'd first like to make a quick shout-out to our sponsor, Storyblocks Audio today. It's a very big online library where you can find royalty-free music, sound effects, and loops. A great library that we always use when sound designing our videos. I've also seen many people use the loops to create their own custom beats or soundscapes. And if you don't like all of that work, you can just search for an entire music track. The amazing thing is that you only need to pay a single price, which allows you to download unlimited audio assets. And this means that everything that you create with the audio files from Storyblocks is yours and can be used commercially. For more information, make sure to click the first link in the description below. I've always been trying to get on Google Street View, but it never happened. So today we are going to kind of fake that, and I'm gonna put myself into Google Street View. So like I said before, you don't need an expensive or special camera. We're just doing this on our SLR camera and we're taking pictures every couple of meters. So Jannik has this camera sitting on a tripod. It's pretty high up because you kind of want to sit at the same level of the Google car taking the Street View pictures. Important is that your camera sits still and then you just grab a picture or shoot a small video clip. It's that simple. You take one, move up a couple of meters and just continue doing that. Now, this thing works best if you keep the same perspective all the time. If you want to make a fan movement and try doing that from the same standpoint, and from there you can then move forward, etc. Kind of see it as how Google Street View actually works. And that's it. You got it, Jannik?
I got it, Jordi.
Now let's jump into Premiere Pro. Nope, it's gonna be After Effects. You could do it in Premiere, and it was the initial idea, but eventually we got so much trouble in it to get the transition right that we decided to do it inside After Effects, which goes so much easier. All right, you can place your two clips in a new composition, but make sure that they overlap a little bit where you want the transition to happen. If you're working with video clips, you're gonna have to cut the last part of your first clip by pressing Ctrl-Shift-D. Then right-click on the top part, go to Time, and select Freeze Frame. After that, we do the same thing with our second clip, but now for the first part. And this way, the two parts that lay on top of each other are freezed in time, and we can handle them now as still images. So if you're working with photos, you could skip this part. The idea now is to morph one clip to another, but we're gonna have to think like Google Street View and not like an effects artist. This means that we're gonna look at the perspective and alignment of the street and buildings. And if that will cut a person weirdly in half, then so be it. That's part of the effect, which makes it look really cool. So start off with decreasing the opacity of the top layer so that we can see the first clip underneath. We're gonna stretch the environment of the bottom clip so that it aligns with the top clip. In order to do that, I'm going to take the anchor tool to move the anchor point to the middle of where I'm going to with the so-called Street View camera. In this case, it's right next to the building and the street. If I would go perfectly forward with my movement, I could have kept the anchor point in the middle. Basically, this anchor point is going to define the start of the stretch. So next, we can open up the scale and position properties. For the scale, you want to disable the constrained proportions. Start the animation for the scale now and the position property by clicking the stopwatch buttons. Then go a little forward in time and change the scale to match it with the buildings from the top layer. You can really stretch it around using the scale and, if necessary, feel free to move the position as well. So that's the first step. By the end of the transition, both shots will be matched. Now we're gonna do the same with the top clip. By the end of the transition, create a keyframe for the position and scale. Make sure that constraint proportions is disabled. This time, move back to the beginning of the transition and stretch the clip to match it with the one below. Alright, this is the basic idea, and you know, it actually also worked inside Premiere Pro. But now comes a part that was very tricky and just unhandy, and in After Effects, it's super easy. And here's how it goes. With the bottom clip selected, hit Ctrl-D to make a duplication from it. On this duplication, we're gonna draw a mask around the perspective of the street. If you come across objects or people like myself who stand on the street, you can mask around them. When you're done, make sure to feather the mask a little bit. Then right-click on this duplicate and choose Pre-compose. Make sure it says to move all attributes into the new composition, and then hit OK. Then on this pre-comp, we're gonna add the effect called CC Scale Wipe. This effect is basically gonna stretch your clip from a given point and direction. So try to find a good spot with the anchor point and direction from the effect where the street is going to be stretched further away to. The idea is that we create the feeling that the virtual camera will glide forward to a good distance. When it sits in place, create a keyframe on the end of the transition for the stretch. Then move back in time and change it to 0. If needed, you could repeat the entire step of duplicating the original, drawing a mask on the perspective, pre-comping it, and animating that again with the CC scale wipe. And now, finally, we can animate the opacity of the very top clip, which still sits at that 50%. So set it to 0, then create a keyframe, move forward in time, and set it to 100 to make the clip fade in. So now that we have our animation, we can top it off with that typical street view motion blur. To do that, we're going to create an adjustment layer and place that on top of the transition. On here, we're going to add the mosaic effect to start with. With the horizontal and vertical blocks, we can define the amount of pixels. Now, during the transition, this can be pretty low. For instance, 200 by 200. When we're at the end of the transition, create a keyframe for both properties. Then go a frame forward in time and increase it some, revealing more of the clip. And this creates that typical image loading effect. Finally, we're also going to add the force motion blur effect to the adjustment layer. Now, first of all, increase the motion blur samples to get a better quality motion blur. You can then increase the shutter angle to around 540, which is a lot. But Street View just happens to have a lot of motion blur. By the end of the transition, create a keyframe for the shutter angle and let it go to 0 a couple of frames later. Don't make it too smooth. This can be a very fast animation. And that's the basic idea behind the Street View effect. Thank you all so much for watching. I really hope that you've learned something new today. Thank you, Storyblocks Audio, for the support. Definitely make sure to check those guys out by clicking that first link in the description below. And as always, stay creative. Some dogs don't know how to listen. There's a clear sign right here. Still, some dogs do prefer to shit on the lawn. Where is it? I was looking for it. Where is it? Where is it?
Ah, no!
Dogs should be better at reading signs.